Dag jongens en welkom bij weer een nieuwe aflevering van Eelco Gaming. We zijn vandaag terug in een nieuwe game. En het is heel eventjes de vraag hoeveel afleveringen hiervan gaan opnemen. Want ik heb geen idee of Rockstar een beetje open staat voor Max Payne 3 op YouTube. Een spel wat ik een tijdje geleden al gekocht heb en waar ik nooit eigenlijk aan toe ben gekomen wat ik nu wilde gaan spelen. Ik ga het spelen in story mode en dat betekent dat ik heel veel verhaal ertussen ga krijgen. Dus het gaat een lekkere, relaxte gameplay worden dit. Met veel verhaal ertussen door waar ik niet doorheen ga liggen ouwen. Ik hoop dat jullie Engels op voldoende niveau is. Want een hoop van het verhaal zal in het Engels zijn. Ik zal het heel even kijken. Volgens mij kunnen we de settings namelijk. Display, audio, voice chat. Modify voice chat settings. Toen bleef hij al hangen. Enable, push to talk. Nope, voice chat, audio. Ik denk niet dat die echt goed in het Nederlands te doen is. Dus hij blijft in Engels. Ik hoop jullie Engels op voldoende niveau is. En anders, dan is dit misschien niet de game voor jullie. Ik zeg, let's go in story mode in Excel. Ik ga er niet doorheen lullen. Dus ik ga alleen commentaar geven op momenten dat het ook echt nodig is. We gaan beginnen met een nieuwe story. Ik ben een tijdje geleden, we gaan lekker op easy spelen. Increase health bullet time rewards is the of the satisfying challenge. Medium. Nou, we gaan gewoon lekker op easy spelen. Lekker snel er doorheen. Ik ga vooral bij deze voor het verhaal. Hij ziet er wel heftig uit, toch? Damn. Voor degene die het verhaal van Max Payne niet kennen. Max Payne is een gast die... waarvan ik eigenlijk volgens mij besef ik alleen deel 1 heb gespeeld. En niet deel 2 en 3. Of in ieder geval niet deel 2. Deel 1 was een heel vaag psychotisch spel. Die sfeer die zie je er nu ook al wel een beetje in terugkomen. Wow, flashbacks. Misschien naar vorige delen. Zo, ik heb deel 3. So I guess I become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death. And I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister. Something rotten in the air, São Paulo, Brazil. I'd arrived in São Paulo a few weeks before. I was working a protection detail for the kind of people who need protection in a town like this. And what kind of town was this? One where I didn't speak the language and they didn't water down their drinks. So for now, we seem to get along just fine. Of course, that was about to change.
Hey, brother.
Hey.
How's the cocktail?
Scotch. I never mix my drinks.
Well, at least not on duty.
Something like that.
Man, that favela is big.
Yep. Nothing like the view of extreme poverty to make a penthouse cocktail party really swing.
I guess they call it trickle-down economics.
That's more graphics.
It's supposed to be a charity thing. Drink and give money. I don't know. Something for the kids. Hey, listen, man. We better look lively. This place is a nightmare. You just got cowboys running security downstairs. Something rotten in the air.
That didn't mean much. There was always something rotten in the air. The family we were protecting were local celebrities, rich parasites with delusions of humanity. The kind of people who end up in glossy magazines or body bags, depending on how their luck runs.
So where are they all? I see Rodrigo over there talking to that guy.
Yeah, I don't know him. That guy next to him, he's some kind of cop. I think, I'm not sure. Serious though, big end cop, anti-gang sort of thing. I can't remember his name.
Who's this guy?
That guy's a plastic surgeon or some kind of surgeon. Tummy tucks and cock implants. Look at Marcel. Still dances like a fool.
Guess that's what a European education and a coke habit will do for Ricky Martin look alike.
That's very funny, Max. Oh, excuse me.
Wie is die man? Wie is die rare baardman?
I was mostly working for Rodrigo Branco, a local businessman. Built things, did some charity, had things named after him, won awards, owned things, people. One of the trophies he had won was his wife, Fabiana. She was hot and wanted to be dangerous. Some good genes trying to fight their way out of a cesspit. She'd married well and was now at leisure to regret her good fortune. They got along as well as any rich workaholic and his younger airhead wife tend to get along. They mostly ignored each other. She spent a lot of time with his cokehead younger brother, Marcello. He was a good time guy if your idea of a good time was an expensive suit, a bottle of champagne, and nothing between the ears. The middle brother, Victor, had just walked in. He was a local politician. Guy was smoother than an oil slick on an iceberg and about as toxic. The rest of the crowd, I didn't know, but I could imagine the types. People who know if they drink enough, they won't have to feel guilty about their good fortune. Suddenly, things turned real ugly. Felt like our hangovers arrived right on cue.
Oh! Oh, dit gaat niet goed. Oh, en gelijk. Shit hits the fan, jongens. Hier gaan we. Let's blow ourselves away out of here.
Passos.
Things had gone from fine to fucked up in about a second, and now there were two idiots at the wheel.
Clear. Got the floor?
Sure.
Look after yourself, bro. Stay safe.
It wasn't my own safety I was concerned about, trophy wife or not. I'd said I would protect the girl. I hoped I hadn't lost my edge, along with everything else.
Okay, press left shift to enter bullet time.
It was time to choose a nasty fall or a bullet to the head.
Okay, way and space, shoot dodge. Way D. Oh, heb ik er nou neergeschoten? Of hebben zij dat gedaan? Hoppa, dat is één. Oké.
That was the boss lady. Only this time she wasn't calling for more vodka in her Cosmo.
Billen, ik signaleer. Digitale virtuele billen, dat wel te verstaan. Oké. Oh, pills, kijk. En dit is waar Max Payne
op... I didn't need a translator to know what these were.
Nope, dat zijn pillen. Examine magazine. Wil je nog andere shit? Nope. Geen andere shit. Oké, examine magazine A.
Trashy magazines and pretty trashy people. I just hoped I could keep them out of the crime section.
Oh, nice. Ik pik de guns gelijk op het moment dat ik overheen loop. Dat is wel handig. Mooi. Oké, maar een leuk appartementje trouwens verder als ik zo... Oh, piano. Kunnen we piano spelen? Play de piano. Terwijl er iemand pak wordt. Misschien dat dit niet het tijdstip is om piano te gaan spelen, besef ik.
It wasn't the time. I was still a little rusty. But the tune was coming together.
Oh.
Just as this new start of mine was about to come to a shuddering halt.
Okay, and now... Oh! Yeah?
Don't be stupid! Don't be stupid! Let her go! Let her go! Come on!
It might have been stupidity, or drunkenness, or maybe both. But before I knew it, I was back taking insane risks, trying to save fallen women.
Jumper! Hoppa!